For a little while now, I've been wanting to make this video. Ever since this article was first released, actually. But other pressing things came up, like the Xbox Series X specs, and of course the new studios and games that might be brought into the Xbox family. But finally, I took a little bit of time, and I really read this whole interview by Phil Spencer from top to bottom, where he opens up about the Xbox brand and where it stood for years. How they lost their identity for a little while and even almost shut down as a whole because Microsoft didn't see Xbox as a profitable brand. All of this was very transparent by Phil Spencer, and it was very eye-opening for a lot of people that love the Xbox brand. And I'm a firm believer that in order to have a future in anything you do, you need to understand your history. And that's something that it would seem that Xbox is getting back to. It's something that they're trying to be better about, understand what they are and what the focal point of the Xbox was all about for all those years ago. But also learn from the failures and make sure to not repeat them in order for the Xbox brand to actually have a chance in such a competitive gaming market. Not to mention one of the fastest, if not the fastest growing markets in the world, which is gaming. And that's where we're going to start with this interview. We're going to see what exactly Phil Spencer's vision is for Xbox and what we can expect in the future. So let's get into this interview because it's one of the best interviews I've read in a very long time, and it gets me excited for Xbox to be all in with gaming. But before we get into this, if you like the video, hit that subscribe button and that like button. The support is greatly appreciated. All right, so first of all, let's just say that the start of this generation for Xbox was one big pile of mistakes. They couldn't launch the Xbox One correctly, and on top of that, they even lost the power narrative. It felt like a different Xbox and an Xbox that truly didn't have an identity. And that's where a lot of the struggles for Xbox this generation stemmed from, because they forgot about their history, and the article says just that when it says this. The company targeted its first two consoles, the Xbox and Xbox 360, predominantly at core gamers, making the machines faster and graphically more powerful than their rivals. The strategy had worked, at least up to a point. While PlayStation and Nintendo were still ahead with the PlayStation 2, 3, and the Wii, respectively, Microsoft had successfully managed to carve out its own niche in the North American market. The Xbox One, however, seemed specifically designed to expand the brand's reach far beyond console gamers. In an attempt to appeal to a broader range of consumers, Microsoft shifted the Xbox One's focus away from gaming towards other entertainment like television and movies. In doing so, it also introduced a number of anti-consumer restrictions, like preventing people from sharing games with their friends and requiring online authentication every 24 hours. Xbox had so many questions surrounding it once all of this came out. It felt like the identity of the brand we all love was starting to go down a path we really didn't like. And it's truly where Phil Spencer's most popular story begins. Here's what he had to say about Microsoft and how they didn't have faith in the gaming industry and especially the Xbox brand. Here's the question that was asked. A few months later, Spencer took over as head of Xbox. Whatever jubilation he felt was short-lived. A few weeks into the job, he got a call from Satya Nadella, Microsoft's new CEO. "I don't actually know a whole lot about why we're in gaming," Nadella told him. Now, I know a lot of people have heard this story before where Satya has to go through all of Microsoft and see which brands deserve to stay. And Xbox being in such a bad way did raise the question of why it even existed. But what most people don't know is what Phil Spencer said to Satya in response. Here's what he's had to say about the brand. It seemed like a good time to ask the question. Spencer was facing a lot of internal scrutiny from his own team. Many developers who had worked on the Xbox One felt let down by Microsoft's big vision. It was, as some told Spencer, not in the line with the soul of what Xbox was. Satya was transparent that there could be a future where gaming isn't a business that Microsoft should be in, Spencer told me. But it's better to have it above the table than below the table, right? Spencer tried to work out what to say to Nadella. He looked at where Xbox had failed and how the brand could be saved, if at all. When he finally called Nadella back, it was to say this: if we're going to stay in the gaming space, then let's make sure we're all in. The last thing I wanted to do was run the gaming organization here as kind of an afterthought of the company and kind of half in, half out. Let's go fix who we are. This to me is one of the most important aspects we've heard from Phil Spencer, and it's honestly very transparent. Instead of telling people at Microsoft to hold out and just invest a little bit more into gaming and maybe we can dig ourselves out of this hole, Phil Spencer was completely honest with Satya and told them the reason the Xbox brand's in shambles is because they aren't fully committed to gaming. Now, of course, that's hard to hear for a lot of Xbox gamers that invested in the Xbox One for so many years, but it's a hard truth that we all knew deep down inside was true. It was something that the Xbox employees knew, and it was something that Phil Spencer knew how to change if Microsoft really wanted the Xbox brand to be successful. Because just like anything in life, if you don't put full effort toward it, you won't be successful and won't be able to compete with people and companies that put everything into a product. All the while, you're competing with one hand tied behind your back. And while it took some convincing from Phil Spencer, Microsoft decided to take gaming serious and to truly go all in. And one of the first things the Xbox did was buy Mojang, the creators of the most popular game in the world. Most people forget just how big that game is. And this signing was the first step Microsoft took to show that they were all in with gaming. Here's what the article said. He pushed Nadella to acquire Minecraft for $2.5 billion, a move that gave Microsoft exclusive control over the most popular game in the world. Microsoft announced the game would continue to be available on all platforms, including those of its direct competitors. It was an unprecedented move for a publisher of Microsoft's size. One of the first calls we got after Minecraft acquisition was from Sony saying, "Are you going to pull it off PlayStation?" Spencer said. And I'm like, why would I do that? People like playing it on PlayStation. This is one of the biggest turning points in gaming, people. This right here shows that Microsoft and Xbox isn't just about a stupid console war. It's about expanding gaming into something we've never seen before. For Sony to call Microsoft and ask if they're going to take away one of their most profitable games on their platform does show a changing of the guard. But it also shows just how cutthroat a lot of the gaming business was for so many years. Now, of course, we know that Microsoft didn't take Minecraft off of PlayStation, and why would they? It will be far more profitable as a game if it's on as many devices as possible. Not to mention, it makes Xbox that much more profitable for Microsoft, which is the most important thing for the brand. But that doesn't mean that Xbox's brand isn't something people should invest in. It's quite the opposite. Just because Microsoft is being more collaborative and diverse doesn't mean that they won't invest in themselves. And that's what the article says here. In the last year, Spencer has made good on his promises to make Xbox a more collaborative and diverse platform. He's brought parts of the Xbox Live to iOS and Android devices, as well as the Nintendo Switch, and pushed more PC integration, something which has pleased a lot of PC gamers who have long argued that Microsoft wasn't doing enough to acknowledge them. But perhaps his biggest investment in the future of Xbox has been in the slow but steady acquisition of a number of well-known studios, including Ninja Theory, Obsidian, and Tim Schafer's legendary Double Fine Studios. "I think people want us to do better with our first-party games," Spencer told me. What people don't realize and see is that having Minecraft under the first-party umbrella, or having all these devices playing Xbox games, and having all these studios joining the Xbox game studios, it all points to Xbox and Microsoft taking gaming far more seriously we've ever seen before. They've bought so many new studios and hired so many developers that expand each studio that they've bought. They're developing more first-party AAA games than they ever have in their history. They're making the most powerful console we've ever seen for the next generation. All of this points to Xbox concentrating on what got them here in the first place, which is the games. Are they changing the business model so it doesn't just concentrate on just an Xbox console? Of course they are, because tech is ever changing and will always change over time. And any company that doesn't change with the times usually ends up being left behind. And that's something that Xbox does not want to happen. And it's something that, as an Xbox fan, we should be cheering. Because for the first time in its history, Xbox is taking the gaming industry extremely serious, and they're trying to compete with every single company that's in the market. They aren't just trying to dominate the console market, they're trying to dominate the entire gaming market, which they've never tried to do before. So it's very eye-opening when you take all of this information and put it together over the last couple of years and truly see what's happened. Because this does feel like one of the best turnarounds in gaming that we've ever seen. Xbox went to one of the companies that might not be around to one of the most dominant brands in gaming, and it's all thanks to them fixing what they broke and learning from their history, and that's good on them. But enough about what I think, tell me what you think about all of this. Do you have more faith in Xbox now? Do you think Xbox would have been shut down without Phil Spencer? What does Xbox need to do for you to trust them again if you don't already trust them now? Are you excited for the next generation of Xbox? Would the gaming industry be the same without Xbox there? Is Xbox going to continue to invest in gaming like they have been? What do you want to see them invest in next? Go down below and let me know. And I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please hit that subscribe button and that like button. The support helps out more than you know. And give me a follow on Twitter @Zocker87. I'm always on there talking games and sharing my latest videos. Also, follow me on Mixer. I recently started streaming on Mixer because I find the community much more engaging and fun. So if you want to hang out and chat with me, I'm very active with my chat and always playing games. The link will be in the description, and I hope to see you guys there. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and until next time, remember, enjoy your gaming. Later.